Another day with unseasonably chilly spring conditions for most of the eastern half of the nation. Matter of fact, most of the nation, just check that, all across the northern Rockies, central plains states, northeast Ohio Valley, all the way down into the south again. Some chilly temperatures, 42 at New Orleans this morning, 36 in Atlanta, 35 all the way down to Jacksonville, Florida. So cold weather continues for much of the nation. Due to a storm system that's locked in over the North Atlantic, pumping in the cool air out of the eastern sections of Canada. And along with that comes the round of sprinkles and light rain showers that we've seen here the past couple of days. In fact, in some areas earlier today, there was a little bit of sleet and wet snow mixed in with some of those showers coming down because the cold air is really locked in the upper levels of the atmosphere. So the precipitation starts as snow or sleet, and most of it makes it to the ground in that form. A couple of sprinkles now moving south of us and some snow continuing in the mountains to the west of us. Gusty winds have made it feel a lot chillier than the thermometer indicates. It's 48 right now at BWI Marshall. That's 10 degrees below what we would expect this time of year. 37 the current temperature at Oakland, where you can see that dark blue shading indicating the cold air is really just persistent out there in those snow-covered areas of the western Maryland mountains and West Virginia as well. 50 Salisbury looks like one of the warm spots, and 51 at La Plata right now in the state. Go west and you're only in the 30s, and it's going to stay chilly tonight. The winds out of the northwest at 5 to 15 miles an hour will make those 30s feel quite a bit colder. Sunset this evening at 7:27. So it doesn't look like the weather map has changed much at all over the past really 48 hours, but this area of high pressure that now stretches from Wisconsin all the way down toward the Florida Panhandle, it is stretching across a large part of the nation and slowly getting a little bit closer. The storm over the North Atlantic is out there, but it's gradually easing away, and eventually high pressure will control the weather here, but only for a short period of time, probably Friday afternoon into Saturday, before another storm forms on this stalled out front to the west of us, and it looks like that will bring us a risk at some rain here before the weekend is over. But it'll be another cold night for the deep south. Parts of North, South Carolina, Northern Georgia, freeze and frost warnings are up once again for tonight. Here with clear to partly cloudy skies, we'll expect those chilly temperatures, a sprinkle or a flurry in the mountains continuing tomorrow, and a slight chance for a sprinkle here, and then mostly sunny skies for Saturday. Saturday looks like the best day of the weekend. Milder temperatures, lots of sun, and then you can see on Sunday clouds come in. Showers are as close as Washington County by 11 a.m. and probably reach Baltimore in the western shore of the bay Sunday afternoon. So the forecast tomorrow, 51 to 56 degrees. That, again, is a few degrees below normal. Northwest winds at 10 to 15 and a slight chance for a sprinkle. On the bay tomorrow, the small craft advisory continues. It's a gale warning now. It'll be a small craft advisory for the day tomorrow. Once again, 3-foot waves on the open waters of the bay due to those brisk northwest winds. A flurry tomorrow in the mountains, and finally some sunshine on Saturday, and temperatures getting back into the 40s. They are slowly crawling out of the deep freeze out in Garrett County. On the eastern shore, 55 degrees with sunny to partly cloudy skies for a couple days. The winds will diminish on Saturday. At the coast, another breezy day tomorrow. A beautiful Saturday, although a little cooler than normal. 7-day forecast around Baltimore. Slight chance for a sprinkle tomorrow, but generally dry and cool for a couple days. Rain arrives Sunday afternoon. Scattered showers Monday, Tuesday. We're back into that chilly air next week with highs in the 40s.